are pretty much at the high for the day on the TSX, give or take a point or two, and it's driven primarily by the financial services. Financial services account for 32% of the move that we're seeing on the TSX today. So good portion of those 70 points coming from the financials. Materials, which includes gold shares, make up about a quarter of the move that we're seeing today. And we'll look to see if that changes through the course of the day. Well, a bus company has pulled up to the Toronto Stock Exchange. Student Transportation of America provides bus services to about 200,000 students in the United States. And at the wheel of the company is Dennis Gallagher. He's the chairman and chief executive officer. He joins me from the Toronto Stock Exchange today. Dennis, congratulations on your initial public offering.
Thanks, Pat. It's a pleasure to be here.
Tell us a little bit more about what your company does and how big it is.
Well, we are currently the fifth largest student transportation provider in North America. Right now we're operating in 11 states in the U.S. and it's a growing market, and we're very excited about the opportunity to be on the TSX today.
What sort of business segments do you have?
We are just a pure play yellow school bus business. So this is just taking kids to school every single school day that there is. That's all it is. We're not an ambulance or trucks or anything else like that. Just pure play yellow school business.
I read in your outline, you have a thing called Managed Services Group. What is that then?
Well, our managed services contract is actually one of our fastest growing segments within the company itself. In fact, about over the last four years or so, this has grown about 32% compounded annual growth rate for us. It represents about 22% of our business. It's actually where we go in and privatize school districts in the U.S. And actually take over the management of the operations. The school districts actually own the vehicles, the facilities, and we provide the drivers, the maintenance, the routing, scheduling, insurance, etc.
You say it's your fastest growing sector overall. Is that something you're going to focus on in the future then, Dennis?
Well, we're obviously pretty excited about this business because it's it is a sector that I think that school districts, as they continue to grow in the U.S., are going to be having capital kind of constraints, and I think they're going to be looking for solutions, and we've put together this solution, which in some cases includes a municipal tax leasing program with them that really provides the school district with a lower cost of capital, a third-party financier, some municipal tax credits, and we get the opportunity to have a new contract in a lot of cases that generally is no capital investment for us. So it's a pretty exciting segment for us.
Dennis, what kind of? Tell me more about these contracts. I mean, how long are they? When you walk into a school board, it's not, obviously can't be a one-year deal. They wouldn't do that. How long do you set them up for?
No, our contracts are generally, Pat, they're between 3 to 8 years. The average contract is 5 years with a five-year renewable contract allowable that you can increase the contract over those periods of time. But our focus has been really in rural, suburban markets throughout the U.S. where they really treat us like partners. We're not treated like a commodity. They're not bidding yellow pencils and yellow buses today. So these are customers that really care about, you know, the service, the consistency. They want the same driver with the same route and the same kids on the same bus every single day. And that is that's what leads to those long-term relationships that we've been able to get.
Who do you compete with then?
Well, in the rural and suburban markets, quite frankly, we're competing with a lot of smaller folks, a lot of the 4,000 or so mom-and-pop companies that are out there. And quite frankly, every once in a while, we will compete with some of the larger national companies like Laidlaw, like First Group, and National Express. Obviously, Laidlaw is well-known in Canada here, but First Group and National Express, two very large UK companies, $2-3 billion transit businesses that wanted to enter into the U.S. market and North American market.
And Dennis, how much money did you raise today, and what are you going to do with it?
Well, we've raised $110 million Canadian, and it will be used to pay off, used as proceeds for our existing investors. This is our seventh year with our existing investors. So, you know, the income trust market really was, for us, a roadway to be able to access some capital, a lower cost of capital for us to be able to continue our business, which is a nice, mature business. The team that I've gotten together is guys that I've worked with for 15 years that are in this business. They know this business, so steady, predictable, contracted revenue business, nice management team that really knows this industry. We intend to use some of the money, obviously, for growth, and we are very excited about the opportunities that this capital market has now is going to afford us.
Well, Well, Dennis, thanks very much for joining us today. We wish you continued success with your business, and congratulations on the IPO.
Thanks, Pat. It's been great. And, you know, half the team is Canadian, and we're very excited about our presence in Canada and in the U.S. here.
Looking forward to seeing you later on, Dennis.
Thanks, Pat.
Dennis Gallagher is the Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of Student Transportation of America. But let's just quickly turn to a second new listing on the Toronto Stock Exchange, and the company is called Quest Air.